stewardship principle number four. Be ready for the king to account for what is his. Verse 19 says, after a long time, the master of those servants returned and settled accounts with them. If we thought more serious about Jesus Christ's return, we would be more focused on investing in the kingdom of heaven. A long time, the master came. Do you know the time of apostles? They talk about the soon coming of the Lord Jesus Christ, 2,000 years. And now, we're still preaching the second or the soon coming of the Lord Jesus. But you know what? In 2,000, we are getting closer than the apostles. We are getting very, 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 very close. He's coming. Do you know why? Because the signs reminding us from day to day. Even the thing that's happening in Christ's church is a warning to everyone who is living here in New Zealand that the master is coming. And when he comes, there is no way you can take your pastor or take me to stand before him to give an account for you. No. If you are someone who cannot talk, you still stand before him and try to answer. Give the account. And do you know 20 years, 30 years, 60 years? That's a long years. And he gave the life to all of us. And we are going to tell him how did we use our time while we are here for him. So when this man master came, he called his three servants to come. Because he wanted to find out what happened to his business, to his money. So the first with the five talent became so proud because he said, see, master, you gave me five and now I have gained five more. Hallelujah. With a big smile, the master, as he looked at his seven, he had opened and been eager to invest what he has been given. He was excited to show the master what he had done. He wanted to please the owner. Yes, he worked so hard because he loved his master. He really appreciated the trust that the master gave him. So he gave five more. And even the one that had the two talents, excited. And he came and told his master, you see, master, you gave me two and I gained two more. Here are they. $1 million. And here both $2 million. With a smile, the master said, you with the five talent, and you with the one, with the two talent, you are very faithful. Well done, you good and faithful servant. Because you are faithful in managing small things, so now I put you in charge of many things. Come on in and share with me my happiness. See the joy when you are faithful. You are welcome by the King of Kings. servant received 3 feet. Because they were so faithful, they received 3 feet. Number one, affirmation. Affirmation means encouragement, build, good recommendation. You see what the master says? He said to the two faithful ones, great job, man. You make me really proud of you. Well done. I appreciate your good work and your faithfulness. Wow. I love to hear that. And the second one, promotion. Because you are faithful in doing these things, I give you more of it. Give you more of it, more responsibility. And the number three, celebration. And because you are faithful, I invite you to come in and join with me. Join in my day. Share with me my happiness. 3 feet received by these two faithful servants. Stewardship principle number 5. Use it or lose it. Because these two faithful ones, they use what God has given them, and they receive more. But the one who had the one, he was so afraid, he didn't want to do anything. He didn't have a personal relationship with his master, so he didn't care. What we think about God is the most important thing about us. A wrong view of God leads to fear. You know, sometimes we get angry with God. I did sometimes. But then I realized I was wrong, so I confess. But when we get upset, angry about God. Do you know what happened? Everything bitter about God. If you know what, then all the goodness of God disappears from us. All we see is something bad about God because of a wrong view. Everything bad. And don't even, to some people, don't even come something quick to them that you swear. I have heard some quick that swear quick. And then say, oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean what I already had. The swear word come out. Wrong view of God leads to fear. A right view of God leads to faith. But when you have a right view of God, look at his faithfulness. Look at his mercy in Christ. Look what he has done to you. Wow. Everything you do, you love, and you don't want to hurt the one you loved because of a right view of God. And you see his mercy, his grace. You see his deliverance, and he's still saved. And you see the salvation he is waiting to give to you. Right view of God. I have something here for us to show. And that looks at the difference between the two faithful servants, a steward and the one who buried his talent. We look at the three people now. The one with the five, the one with the two, we call them faithful. So this is the one with the five talent, and this is the one with the two talent, and this one, and the one in the middle, that's the one with the one. Just pretend. And you are the unfaithful one. We just pretend. And that one and that one, they are faithful one. So we are going to read together this. So first of all, the faithful one. We read together, the faithful one. The first two were determined to make a profit. The unfaithful one. The third was determined not to take a loss. The faithful one. The first two were willing to work hard and take risks. The third was lazy and took no risks. The first two wanted to advance the master's money. The third with what matter to the master. The first one, the first one, invested. The faithful one. The other one wasted. The faithful one. The first two sure of blessing and of dealing. The faithful one sure of learning and of broken. The first two knew the master. The faithful one. No, you are not really. Yeah, what we suspect is part of the movie. Use it or was it? So the master called the unfaithful one, the one with the one talent. You are so wicked because he did not love his master. And he called him lazy because he was not willing to do anything for his master's kingdom. The kingdom is not just about don't do this and don't do that. It is about doing what we are given to do. We do not love God and our neighbors if we are determined only to do enough to save our own soul.